welcome back to the afternoon sessions on the first day of International Business Ethics Conference, or IBEC. And IBEC is brought to you by the Center for Ethics and Organization Culture, Sudarpo Sastro Sastomo, and sponsored by Central for International Private Enterprise, and also Astra Agro Lestari, Jam Krindo Samuda Indonesia, Pelindo 3, and Pelindo 4. With me, David Manalu, your host for this afternoon. The next few hours, we're going still learning about ethics in business, big challenge, reinforcing ethical business and integrity practices. In implementing business ethics right away, or embodying it from the theory into the everyday practice, we sometimes confuse where to begin, whether it is effective or attainable, also measurable. On this session, we will learn on how to make business ethics become a part of business strategy or business model. The Center for Ethics and Organization Culture, Sudarpo Sastro Sastomo, or PEBOS, under PPM Management, has created something new, something that might be the solution on how to embed the business ethic model with the new system. And I'm sure you're not going to miss this session. Now, with no further ado, please welcome PEBOS team, PPM Management, in our third session with its title, Ethical Model Organization, that will be represented by the head of the Centers of Research and Product Development of PPM Management, Bapak Andi Ilham Said, PhD, and will be facilitated by one of PPM's management core trainer and consultant, Ms. Siti Nuraisha Suwanda, a faculty member, trainer, and researcher who teaches marketing and strategic management classes at PPM School of Management. She took interest in consumer behavior and marketing analytics. Now she's building a research stream in consumer boycott and marketing analytics. Aside from teaching classes and conducted research, she's involved in community development under the umbrella of PPM School of Management and independently as the founder of Circle for Women, a mental health initiative to empower women through support group. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Siti Nuraisha. Hi, Siti.
Hi, how are you, David? Thank you for the introductions. How is everyone doing? Okay, let's just start the session. Okay, so assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bapak-Ibu sekalian, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining International Business Ethics Conference 2021 with the title of Ethics in Business, Big Challenge. Okay, so my name is Siti Nuraisha Suwanda, but you can call me Sitin. I'm from PPM Management as moderator for these sessions, right? And so the topic that will be discussed in the session is about ethical cultivation model in organizations. I think I can safely say that this session is one of the most anticipated sessions because we will finally reveal the cultivation model that has been researched by PBOS teams for a couple of years, if I'm not mistaken, yeah? So these stations, ladies and gentlemen, will be presented by Pak Andi Ilham Said, yeah, from PPM of Management. But he is famous for Pak Ais, so let's just call him Pak Ais from now, yeah, ladies and gentlemen. So now, because we need a friendlier and warmer atmosphere. But right now, let me introduce you a little bit about him. So Pak Ais is the head of Center for Research and Product Development of PPM Management. He in early 2000, he was the assistant dean of academic affairs and academic sections in PPM School of Management. In 2003 to 2005, he was also the leader of Majalah Management. And from that, he was the director of management educations at PPM Management. And since 2003 until 2007, Pak Ais was the head of PPM School of Management. Okay, a couple of roles at once, so he must be a very mighty man, I can safely say, ladies and gentlemen. And since 2007 to 2011, he was the director of PT Binaman Utama and PT Pustaka Binaman Presindo. And in 2011, he was the chairman of advisory board of IICD. Next, he was the president director of PPM Management, ladies and gentlemen. And after that, he was the professional staff of strategic management expertise of PPM management. And since then, since 2017 up until now, Pak Ais is the head of Center for Research and Product Development of PPM Management. So I think based on Pak Ais' CV, he's a very professional and very very prominent, yeah, in his field. I think we can safely say that. So okay, he's already in the screen. How are you, Vice? How are you?
I'm fine. Good afternoon. Thank you for your introduction.
Sure, of course. You look so happy and glowing, sir. Oh, yeah. Are you ready to present the lecture?
Yes. Yes, of
ready?
Course.
Okay. So yeah, I think, ladies and gentlemen, yeah, I can invite Pak Ais to share with us the topic. I, since you're ready, I guess the screen and time is yours. Pais, you may start the lecture.
Okay. Please let me share the material. Sure. This is the material. It's already shared?
Yes.
Oh, you okay. Can see. Thank you, Sitin. First of all, let me say thanks for everybody, every organization who support this conference, international conference. Since the first we established PEBOS, we already commit to contribute to the business, to the implementation of the what ethics should be in the organization, especially in cultural. To establish how the cultural in organization according to the ethics, basically. And thank you very much for all sponsors who already support this this event. Okay, let me start with the idea, the reason why we really want to have this model. First, we find out that it's very important to have the model in this digital and open era, and it's also important for organization to implement the ethical issues in their activities. And this why we have to have that ethical situation in the organization, ethical culture in organization. Since in this era, the more we need to have a networking, the more we need to have a collaboration. Then if we want to have a collaboration, if we want to have a partner, of course we have to have a trustworthy. We have to be understand, we have to be believe that we are conducting transparency, conducting ethical activities, ethical issues in our organization. We adherence with the ethical issues. That's why we need to have this model. Also, we find out that not many, as mentioned by Vasquez, that it's scarce to have this kind of model. So we believe that by having this model, we contribute significantly to the business in activity in the business. And also this model in line with the management corporate mission and values, where in the starting establishing PPM it's already have a commitment to give the nation with the management concept based on the ethical philosophy like we have Pancasila and so on. So we do the theoretical review before we develop this model, as usually using by researchers. We find out, according to Ambrose, that ethics is one of the most critical issues, so meaning it's very important to have ethical issues in the organization. And by fairer, we find out that organization need to employ people who have more principle, moral principles. Yeah, because at the same time, the business need to earn money. So there is a balancing between earning money, but make sure that we use the moral principle in achieving the targets. Then also we find out state, yeah, saying that to manage the behavior, companies need to develop significant code ethics. So by having the code of ethics, which is provide, which is socialized by training, and we can strengthen the ethical behavior. So then we develop the research. We use the four stages basically. It's used normally doing also by other model. First, of course, we do quantitative research. We design the research. Then we find out that unit analysis and sample is employee level. And then we stratified sampling demand employees in Indonesia so far. Yeah. Then third thing, we do data collection. We're using online survey. And then after that, we analyze the data using the descriptive and inferential statistic using SPSS and AMOS. So we do two statistical tools. Then after that, we find out the model is using a total 2,101 respondent. Actually, we have 5,079, but after we screening the response, we find out that less than half of them can be used in this model. But it's quite enough. 2,100 is quite big response that make us believe that believe that the model is quite valid according to the research requirement. Then we find out that this I'm sorry because more of the respondent coming from the men, 76.9%, and woman is 23%. That is because we do the research in some companies where the employee is dominated by men. Based on age, we have a quite distributed respondent, 36.6 coming from 20 to 30 years old. It's the modest. Then based on the level of education, a bachelor degree dominate almost 50%. It's also represent the population. Length of work, most of the more than 10 years, it make us more confidence that the more experienced people become the respondent. Then and this is the interpretation. We find out after using the statistical tools, all variable find out is significant. And in ethical belief of adherence to ethical behavior is significant. So ethical belief of adherence to ethical behavior is significant. It's very important. But it means that ethical beliefs is a very, very important factor to make sure how ethical behavior is implemented in this organization. Then the second factor, it is a moderator factor, we find out after the process in statistical, that is organization support is significantly strengthening, this is modest factor, adherence to ethical behavior. So meaning ethical belief already significant, but organization support can make it more strengthened by having the positive support from the organization. And we find also the byproduct of this survey that age has a positive effect on adherence to ethical behavior, meaning older generation are more obedient. This is the we find out from the research. Organization support, that's what we find out, it's really increasing adherence to ethical behavior. There are four things here. This will be explained later. This is the model. So we find out the model. Finally, we find that the model. The model is exactly like this. So this model is already proved by research, and we do the what the staging scientist is staging in research. So we confidence with the result. Participant, I know that in participant many some of the participant coming from a student who is will do thesis, yeah, thesis in the short time, yeah. You can use this model because it's already proved based on our research. So you can use this model for your thesis, yeah. So you might come as the first student to use this model in your company. So after we develop this model, we already develop the way we audit this model. So you can use the audit tools to know how your company from this objective of the model. So you can do the thesis framework and audit your company, and then you find out the result, and then you can see the gap happen in your company. Then you can fulfill that gap by give suggestion what your company should do to implement to get more ethical, let's say, index in your company. So in the model, as we mentioned before, actually we have two factor, ethical belief and adherence to ethical behavior. So dependent variable is adherence to ethical behavior, depend on ethical belief. So ethical belief is very important factor. Without ethical belief, you cannot implement, you cannot hoping that people in your organization adherence to ethical behavior. Then organization support coming as a moderator variable, meaning by having organization support, then the implementation ethical culture in your organization becomes strengthening. But without ethical belief, this model saying that only organization support cannot implement ethical behavior in the organization, because organization support only show up in this model as a moderator variable. But the moderator variable here is significantly influence the relation, you know. So because it is significantly influence the relation, then the role of the organization support is become very important also to make sure that our ethical culture is really happen in your organization. What is factor support the ethical belief? There are three level. First, the most important thing is the personal ethic. So that is a personally belief, personally value, personal value have by people. which already happened maybe since they are very young, and influenced by people, by parents, by community, by education, and so on. Make them grow up with this belief. Yeah. For instance, they believe that we have to do honesty in everything. It's already since they are very young. So this is very important, and unfortunately, it's very difficult to develop. But they're still possible to improve this one. And the second one is ethical functional ethics, meaning that is an ethics believed by all of the function in the organization. There should be a functional in operation, in marketing, in finance, in human resources, and so on, technology, and so on. That's they believe that many activity, many practicing in this functional area is based on ethical or not ethical. The other, number three, is organizational ethics. Ethics in the highest level of organization. How organization impose people, impose all of the worker, all of the activities in organization to really implement or using the ethical decision-making, ethical activity, and ethical process in organization. And what the organization support? We find out at least four factors support the organizational support. First, of course, the leader support. As leader support for ethics. So top down, tone up from the leader to saying that this organization really appreciate, really reward people who implement ethical, do the ethical things in organization. The second one is code of ethics. Organization support should have something you write down in the regulation, you write down in the paper, as we call that code of ethics, which is really implement in the organizational daily life. Okay.
Guys, sorry, yeah. can you click one button so the model will circle okay. around?
Okay. Oh yeah, sorry. Yeah. This is the model. How many times more so I can?
We still have 10 minutes.
Oh, okay. Organization support, I continue. The other number three factor in organization support is ethic reporting channels. So meaning organization should give a channel, give a chance for the people to report what happened in the ethical practicing in the organization, which we call usually whistleblowing. But notes here that it should be not only violation that you report, but the good practicing also should be reported. So we will have quite fair enough balancing between what happened positively or what happened negatively. So we can see the organization in the both sides, not only negative things. Yeah. The number four is how you disseminate the ethic program. Is there any socialization from the company? Is there any procedure, system and procedure from the company who support reward and punishment to the implementation of ethics in the organization? So there are four activities. Then adherence to ethical behavior is the target, meaning this is a kind of measure, how you know that your company already achieved the ethical target. The measure is how people comply, how people adherence to ethical behavior. And there's three factors that we can see to support this variable. First, the information you give and you know in the organization is no hoax information or information already valid, and people do it openness, transparency with the honesty. The second one is the using how people in the organization use the facilities. Are they use the facilities appropriately or not? If you see that people in the organization really use the facilities in appropriately, in a good manner, and responsible in responsible, it means that organization already in the level of implementing the ethics. And the number three is how people from top, bottom to top, top down, all of the leader in those organization use the authority given by the organization rightfully. So there's no abuse of power, for instance. So by seeing that three factor already happen in the organization, then it means that adherence to ethical behavior already happened in this organization. So this is the model. This is the model we already proved in the research. Then we hope that company, if they want to implement, want to know how they implement the ethical issues, they can use this model. Then, if you want to know in deeply this model, you can follow the workshop we do for the continuing of this conference. You can register to the workshop so you can experience there. You know the concept more detail, and then you will have a chance to using this model, to practicing this model. And also, you can even ask some people in your organization to give information, to give data, to be a respondent to the small research. Then you will know how your organization in this model. So as we mentioned before, after you know the position, then you can have a target. You can have a strategy to be higher level in implementing ethics in your organization. It's very important if you have the high level implementing ethics. It's very important for your partner, very important for your customer, for your supplier, even for your competitor, to respect to your company. We can see that all of the companies who success in the world, almost all, some company success before, then they violation the ethic regulation as happened in the USA 10 years ago, then it's collapsed. So ethics is very important for the company to show how they stand for the ethical in doing business ethics, in practicing business ethics. So this is a kind of explanation about what is ethical belief. Ethical belief, that is a morality character base. That you get it from your experience and practicing. What kind of practicing? For instance, practicing behavior of honesty, courage for what is right, say courageously, this is right and this is wrong, and being a person, a fair person, a generous person in the activity, in the organization. by understanding the ethical belief, then you can, meaning you can explain, you can identify, and you can cite example what is the ethical behavior based on your value. Of course, we know that many ethical things is not only talk about black and white. Some is average gray area, but some people has a stand value that saying I have to do this based on my belief. For instance, some company pay their supplier 2 weeks. The other company saying, oh, pays 2 months, as usually do in the usually happen. So they pay 2 months. Why you should pay your customer 2 months? Because yeah, this is happened. But some company saying, no, I pay the supplier right after they give me invoice. Sebelum keringat kering, saya in Indonesia, I pay my customer sebelum keringat kering. Now this is kind of value that happening by leader in the organization, and it might be different. But that, so some people say this is ethic, it's not ethic. That's why organizations should decide what kind of ethics they want. Now, personal ethics, as mentioned before, set like a more moral principle, yeah, by helping people. So personal values are conception of value inside belief by people or in individual, yeah, or group. Yeah. If you have some value and then you group, then your group having the same value, and that is the value of the group based on your belief together. And the principle, the other principle is personal ethics refer to the implementation of the value and in everything one does. Yeah. So if you have this value, everything you do, you will do. You will do this based on the value you have. People, some people say that I always transparent or be honest to my friend, and they do it to everything they do with their activity in networking, in relation with their friend. Some people say that personal ethic as morality. Morality meaning right or not right, right or wrong. Yeah. And this principle already instilled during childhood. So long time. That's why I said that's very difficult to change this. But that's still possible to change the this principle.
Nice, a friendly reminder that 5 minutes, yeah, 5
okay,
minutes.
Thank you. So I will make it short. Functional ethic, as I mentioned before, that there is based on the functional area. So there's a different ethics in production, in marketing, in human resources. So people have their own ethical in functional area. In organization ethic, we talk about how organization respond to the internal and external stimulus. Organization ethic express the value of organization or its employees or other entities irrespective of governmental regulatory laws. An organization form when individual with varied interests and different background unite on common platform. So this unity will develop the organizational ethic. Okay, then we have organizational support. This is a system in organization that contribute to creating and maintaining compliant behavior in ethical culture in this organization. It includes formal system like SOP, policy and procedure, formal decision making, how they make a decision, in training, in informal system also, as a role model and unwritten norms of daily behavior, all of the employee in the company, from leader to the staff. And we have leader support for ethic, how leader can show affirmatively positive toward ethical implementation there in their organization, informally or formally. This role of the leader is very important to forcing to motivate people to do ethical things if the leader is really show how the ethical implementation in their organization. Enforcing organizational code of ethic is very important also to have this, so people know that this organization has a regulation, then we can refer on, we can discuss based on that. Not only people in organization, if you show it up in your website, then your partner will know that you have code of ethics. You already implement ethics in your organization. So it's important to show it to your partner, so they will judge you based on the ethical things. They will rank you, they will classify you as an organization who practicing ethical in your organization life. Okay, ethics reporting channel, as I mentioned, usually we call it whistleblowing. This is a formal structure and system established by organization to receive advices and to report any ethical violation. But I mentioned not only ethical violation, basically, yeah. There should be possible to report that something good, yeah. Something positive happened in your organization, so it's really support you. As my, I saw the discussion by CIC before and CIP, this is movement by people in the organization or country to give reward organization who do the positive things in saying no to bribery and no to corruption, giving a reward for the integrate company. Ethic dissemination program is also important. If you have already the system, you have already the code of ethic, you need to disseminate. If not, it's only in your document, not live in the active daily activity. So adherence to ethical behavior, there are three: compliance with ethical principle, demonstrate and able to practice ethical behavior, then it's really influenced by individual factor in organization. Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm timing it off already.
Oh, okay. So this is the, I think this is the only three last slide. First, information validity. This is factor show how you already implement ethics. You have appropriate use the facilities, and also you have right use of authority. Actually, I already explained it during the model. So ethical application, there is in ethical belief, we need to improve ethical understanding. In adherence to ethical behavior, we need to improve the practices of ethics through civilization, example, role model. In organization support, we need to educate leader to understand. We need to ensure that strategy, policy, system, procedure are accordance with the ethical principle. Also, we need to manage leader in the company to develop a human resources system which include a pressure system established a work climate that support implementation of ethical behavior. Meaning your system, your resources system should give a reward for those who implement, who practicing ethical things, and penalty if you violate the ethical things. I think that's it. Conclusion, as a conclusion, our research confirmed this model already, and we already launched this model to help organization to know how they implement, how they cultivating the ethical culture in the organization.
Thank you, Faiz.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the lecture, Faiz. I think that was a really comprehensive model explaining how to cultivate ethical model in organizations, right? Because I believe that business ethics are important to build values, culture, and behavior within an organization that will eventually lead to revenue generations and also objective realizations. So ladies and gentlemen, now we are moving to the question and answer sessions. I think there are a couple, actually multiple questions already submitted to the questions and to the question box that we have. And I will select a couple of them. Yeah, I will open the first sessions because there, I think I can say that there are so many audience that are interested in this model that has been conducted that came from the research that has been conducted since 2018 to 2021 with 5,000 of respondents, right? That is next selected to 2000, which is a very, very prominent research. Anyway, I will choose the questions if that's okay. So we have a couple of questions and yeah, we will pick a question from Mr. Ismanto Faiz.
Yeah.
Mr. Ismanto asks, you said that almost all companies applying business ethics were successful and some others were not. Would you be so kind to show us some examples of companies which have been successful and those which are not successful? Thank you. Faiz, you can answer that question. Thank you.
Okay. I will answer in Bahasa. I agree with the idea of Ibu Santi. Terima kasih, Ibu Santi. Yeah. Jadi Pak Ismanto ya, jadi memang kita melihat bahwa kalau polisi itu suka bilang gini nih, setiap kali ada suatu kecelakaan lalu lintas, maka pasti didahului dengan adanya suatu pelanggaran, gitu ya, pelanggaran lalu lintas. Nah, seperti itu kan. Nah, di dalam organisasi sebenarnya juga berlaku juga seperti itu. Jadi kalau ada organisasi yang celaka gitu ya, dalam arti kemudian mengalami masalah, itu biasanya ada suatu pelanggaran yang dilakukan. Pelanggaran itu baik itu sifatnya etik atau pelanggaran dalam cara berbisnis ya. Jadi mungkin saya beri contoh di Amerika pernah ada perusahaan yang sangat terkenal gitu ya, number one in the world, memberikan konsultansi tentang laporan keuangan gitu ya. The number one in the world loh ya. Begitu kemudian mereka melanggar etik dengan memberi laporan palsu gitu tentang laporan keuangan suatu perusahaan, dalam sekejap langsung hancur gitu ya. Jadi ini menunjukkan bahwa practicing ethics itu sangat penting gitu ya. Perusahaan yang sukses banyak sekali. Jadi perusahaan-perusahaan yang menjunjung tinggi ethics itu atau kita mengatakan perusahaan yang sukses itu hampir semua menjunjung tinggi ethics dengan sangat baik. Jadi katakanlah kalau kita sebut Astra atau mungkin McD misalnya, itu sangat mereka sangat sensitif dengan hal-hal yang tidak etis gitu ya. Misalnya ada yang menemukan tidak etis misalnya mempekerjakan karyawan di bawah umur gitu ya. Kalau ada yang sampai melaporkan seperti itu, mereka sangat malu gitu. Bahkan mereka akan bertindak sangat cepat misalnya. Atau misalnya tadi Exxon ya, itu Exxon ya tadi dijelaskan itu kalau nggak salah saya pernah dapat ini juga bahwa sistemnya itu sangat kuat untuk mengunci supaya even pimpinannya itu mau korup, sistemnya akan menolak gitu. Jadi memang sudah dikunci gitu ya. Misalnya nih, seorang direktur tidak bisa secara individu sendiri untuk menandatangani suatu pengeluaran gitu ya. Jadi kalau dia menyuap, mau menyuap misalnya, dia sendiri nggak bisa kalau dia sendiri. Berarti paling tidak ada orang lain yang harus kerjasama gitu ya. Iya kalau orang lain itu setuju gitu ya. Kalau dia nggak setuju, dia nggak bisa. Jadi nah itu cara-cara organisasi locking, mengunci supaya etikal itu tidak terjadi. Jadi kita kenal juga Samudra Indonesia ya, Ibu Santi di sana, Pak Darpo itu dari awal sudah betul-betul mengatakan, kemudian menuliskan, menyampaikan bahwa kita ini organisasi yang harus menjunjung tinggi etika. Nah, sampai sekarang perusahaannya makin besar, besar, besar gitu ya. Jadi saya kira hampir semua perusahaannya itu saya tuh punya nilai-nilai etika yang sangat besar. PPM saya kira juga satu organisasi yang bisa survive ya. Orang banyak mengatakan kalau kamu nggak mempraktekkan etika tidak akan survive, nggak mungkin. Kita sudah membuktikan ya selama 54 tahun kita tidak pernah menerima suap gitu ya. Bahkan pernah beberapa kejadian kita dicoba gitu kan ya, ingin disuap tetap tidak mempan. Bahkan kita sampai pernah tidak dibayar gitu ya. Jadi pernah kita melakukan konsultansi tidak dibayar oleh perusahaan besar gitu ya, hanya karena kasirnya itu minta kickback gitu. Ya mungkin kickbacknya tidak seberapa dibanding nilai kontraknya ya. Tapi bagi direktur waktu itu bukan soal nilai kontraknya, tetapi melanggar etika itu yang jauh lebih penting gitu ya. Nah ini contoh-contoh. Akhirnya kalau cerita itu akhirnya perusahaan besar itu setelah 10 tahun kemudian dia akhirnya bayar ke PPM juga karena di laporan keuangannya kok ada supplier yang belum dibayar-bayar, kenapa ini gitu ya. Akhirnya dia datang ke PPM, kita bilang wah itu minta dibayar ininya kasirnya, wah karena sudah berganti pimpinan dia kemudian mengatakan nggak benar gitu ya. Akhirnya mereka akan lebih hormat lagi kepada PPM bahwa kita rela untuk mengorbankan sales gitu ya. Padahal kita juga butuh uang gitu ya, tapi daripada kita mengorbankan etika, lebih baik kita mengorbankan uang. Nah itulah contoh-contoh banyak organisasi yang sukses dan banyak juga yang gagal gitu ya. Karena.
Wah, terima kasih Pak Ais atas jawabannya. Thank you for the answer, Pak Ais. So yes. Let's move on to the next questions, ladies and gentlemen. So tadi, okay, so earlier Pak Ais already mentions a couple of names of the companies that have been successful in applying ethics, business ethics, and he mentioned one of the example was Samudra Indonesia. And now, ladies and gentlemen, since Bu Shanti is also one of the panelists, and yeah, we have one questions that will be answered by Bu Shanti. If that's okay with you, Bu Shanti, right? So, yeah. Bu Shanti is going to answer one of the questions, if that's all right with you, Pak Ais. So we have a question from Pak Sandi. The questions was, okay, so since morning we discussed ethics, where mostly all speakers take up issue of graft, corruptions, and bribery, etc. Are there any other measurements of ethics besides those above, such as behaviors, capability, ability of decisions making, and independent? That is the questions, and will be answered by Bu Shanti. Bu Shanti, are you there?
Silakan, Bu.
Ya, yeah. Bu Shanti, saya persilahkan untuk menjawab pertanyaan yang ini nih, Bu. Oke. Okay. Hello. Okay, so I guess maybe maybe Bu Santi sedang berhalangan gitu ya. Nanti kita we can get
Santi ya. Sambil menunggu mungkin bisa dikontak langsung juga ke beliau ya di telepon atau. Begini ukuran ini memang kan kadang-kadang etika itu kan ukurannya hitam putih ya, ada apa enggak gitu ya. Tapi kalau beberapa organisasi sudah membuat ukuran ya. Kayak misalnya tadi SAIP bekerja sama dengan CAC atau KAKI ya, Komite Anti Korupsi Indonesia itu tadi yang dipresentasikan Pak Eri dan Mr. Hansen kalau salah ya. Nah, itu mereka sudah buat juga standar gitu ya. Jadi ada 71 list of question. Jadi ada 71 pertanyaan yang harus dijawab ya apa tidak gitu ya. Jadi kalau seluruhnya dijawab ya gitu ya, oh, berarti itu organisasi yang betul-betul sudah memiliki suatu fundamental ya yang baik di dalam mencegah suap dan mencegah korupsi. Kalau sudah menjawab itu. Tapi kalau menjawab setengahnya udah lumayan gitu ya. Nah, berarti kan ada setengahnya lagi yang harus kita jadikan sebagai target untuk kita perbaiki. Tapi ya kembali jawabannya itu memang ukurannya ya apa tidak. Anda mempunyai sistem nggak gitu ya, misalnya ya apa tidak. Ada 71 pertanyaan, jadi kalau nanti organisasi itu masuk dalam KAKI, maka kemudian mereka akan disuguhkan nih 71 nih kamu. Nah, itu menjadi ukuran ya. Ada banyak lagi kalau kita ada banyak lah kayak misalnya ISO juga itu sebenarnya sih ukuran juga kan, international standard operation ya, standar berarti kan ukuran juga. Nah, itu juga bisa juga ada ukuran-ukuran yang diakui. KPK juga membuat juga ukuran yang disebut sebagai singkatan itu profit, professional in ethic, professional ethic misalnya, itu juga ukuran juga. Jadi sebenarnya banyak sih ukuran-ukurannya, ukuran-ukuran untuk memastikan di situ, memastikan apakah gift itu berapa tadi, $100 apa berapa, nah, itu memang harus dibuat ukuran. Saya kira gitu sih Tim.
Oke, baik, terima kasih. Pak Ais atas jawabannya ya. Oke, baik, selanjutnya mungkin sambil menunggu ya, kita lanjut dulu nih ke satu pertanyaan berikutnya ya. Pak Ais, jadi ini ada, oh kenapa saya jadi bahasa Inggris ya? Bapak Ibu mohon maaf. Oke, so ladies and gentlemen, we can move on to the next questions ya. So this is a very interesting question. Pak Ais, let's just choose one, yeah. This is from Miftah from on the weekend, Pak Ais. So the question from Miftah is, who defines a good business ethics from bad business ethics? What could happen if a country enforces bad business ethics to some business model in the country? Should the company comply or should they stick to the good ethics learned from elsewhere? Maybe this is talking about ethical dilemma, right? When the government enforced a company with bad business ethics, should the company comply to that or not? Wow, this is a very serious question indeed. You can answer the the question, guys.
Yeah, based on the model, actually the ethical personal belief, yeah, very important. So in personal belief, there should be morality. Morality means it's very clear. Is it the factors in based on morality is only based on right or not right? Yeah. So siapa yang harus who decide right or not? Actually. Market should decide. So ask the customer basically first. Yeah, the first one is the customer. Customer will choose the right and the wrong thing. But in some situation, customer may overlook which is ethics or not ethics. Why overlook? Because they are covered by other reason like economic reason and so on. Yeah, for instance, they may see that they use the product actually using from non-ethical sourcing, like coming from the forest, tree cut from the forest illegally, and then it coming to the market. And actually, you know that, you know exactly that it is not ethics, but the price is very, very low. And then you have the other product, the price is higher, but guarantee coming from the legal activities, for instance. Why, where you choose? Some customer, I don't care with that, then they just choose the cheaper one. But in some country in Europe now, it's very important. They will not choose that if you don't have a certificate so that it is legal. Yeah, that's why in this situation, government as the regulator should come up to solve this problem, to solve this situation. Because the market mechanism is not doing. Yeah, it's not doing. That's why we need regulation from the government to say that even this is cheaper, you cannot buy this because it is violate the rule. That's why we need. Yeah. So the answer is actually customer, basically customer will decide. Except if customer overlook or cover by something other reason that make it do not follow the ethical procedure. Yeah. What the other?
Okay, baik Pak Ais, terima kasih. Thank you for the answer. Ini mungkin supaya lebih hidup ya sesi tanya jawabnya. Kayaknya nggak apa-apa juga ya kalau kita dalam bahasa Indonesia ya. Oke, okay. Nah ini Bu Santi sudah hadir nih bersama kita ya.
Halo, Bu.
Bu Santi, apa kabar nih Bu Santi?
Baik.
Baik ya. Oke, okay, baiklah. Wah, Bu Santi ini tetap semangat nih Bapak Ibu sekalian dan akan menjawab satu pertanyaan ya Bu Santi. Baik. Yang ada di kolom question and answer sessions. Oke, okay, jadi pertanyaannya gini nih. Oke, okay, Bapak Ibu, jadi dari tadi pagi kita sudah membahas bisnis ethics, lalu pertanyaannya adalah apakah ada measurements yang lain ya yang bisa mengukur etika Bapak Ibu sekalian? Boleh silahkan waktu dan layar saya persilahkan kepada Bu Shanti untuk menjawab.
Ya, oke, okay. Bismillah ya. Yes. Kalau kita di satu korporasi kan sekarang ada, terutama kalau kita perusahaan terbuka, itu ada compliance ya, ada tata laksana ya kan. Jadi sebagai seorang karyawan dan di dalam satu organisasi kita harus patuh kepada tata laksana dan juga patuh kepada corporate culture yang memang ditanamkan menjadi spirit daripada atau rohnya dari organisasi itu. Dan juga aturan permainan secara internasional ada, misalnya dengan adanya ISO standards ya. Itu ada macam-macam kan yang tadi pagi disinggung oleh Pak Eri dan ya Kaki dan Saipi tadi kan itu adalah yang menyangkut dengan anti bribery, whistleblowing. Nah, itu adalah salah satu measurement atau ukuran untuk mengukur apa namanya dari segi piranti pengawalannya secara struktural, secara formal ya dari tata laksana. Itu yang menunjang. Nah, yang dipaparkan oleh Pak Andi tadi adalah model kamu namanya tadi Pak Ais. Itu kan mengenai konteks dari mana kita menanamkan satu ethical behavior.
Ya, ya kan? Pembudayaan etika di organisasi.
Ya, jadi kebudayaan dalam kita berperilaku di dalam satu organisasi. Tapi tadi terpulang juga bahwa kita ada mulai dari diri kita sendiri dulu. Nah, kalau kita bicara dari diri, yaitu aspek kejujuran, saya sebagai waktu anak kecil ya, nggak boleh bohong. Itu udah basic tuh. Harus jujur, ya kan? Jangan menipu, jangan suka nipu. Nipu dengan maksud licik gitu ya. Kan kita kan anak-anak suka begitu ya. Jadi kita terus accountability ya, tanggung jawab. Itu dari kecil kita kan sebetulnya dengan langkah-langkah sederhana. Kalau yang konkret dalam hubungan dengan organisasi, saya ingat sekali ketika saya kecil, Bapak mempunyai mobil pribadi, ada mobil perusahaan. Nah, kalau mobil perusahaan itu ada supir yang di assign untuk itu ya. Jadi kalau kami mau bepergian, Bapak sudah mengiming-iming memperingatkan. kalau kamu pergi pakai mobil pribadi, Bapak. Kalau waktu itu kita mungkin umurnya yang udah punya SIM nih, ya kan? Jadi dia bilang, kalau kamu mau berpergian untuk kepentingan pribadi kamu, pakai mobil pribadi, Bapak. Kalau mau pakai mobil dinas, nggak boleh. Kalau kamu perlu mobil dinas, itu harus supirnya supir dinas. Kamu tidak boleh. Karena itu adalah mobil yang diperuntukkan untuk saya, Bapak, sebagai pejabat di perusahaan. Jadi yang bertanggung jawab adalah Bapak dan supir dari perusahaan. Jadi itu udah diwanti-wanti tuh. Itu satu basic ya, yang kita mulai dari rumah. Hal-hal gitu. Nah, sama seperti kalau di perusahaan kan ada tata laksana. Tadi kan ada sanksi juga kalau kita tidak patuh kepada tata laksana. Jadi hal-hal itu tadi di dalam lingkaran-lingkaran yang tadi utarakan oleh Pak Andi di dalam ininya, dalam modelnya tadi, kan ada adhere, ethical or support, ya. Jadi itu tata laksana. Kalau yang di sebelah kiri kan ada ethical behavior as a company, as a employee of a company, ethical behavior of yourself. Jadi itulah piranti-piranti yang mendukung. Lalu memang harus dari atas, ya kan, walk the talk seperti tadi yang saya utarakan pada sesi kita ini pagi hari. Ya, bedanya harus konsekuen. Hal lain tadi kalau kita bicara tata laksana itu kan ada direktur compliance. Makanya sekarang banyak perusahaan diwajibkan, kalau di sektor keuangan wajib tuh punya sektor direktur compliance dedicated, ya kan? Nggak boleh dirangkep itu. Compliance itulah yang mengawal tadi. Jadi itu sekedar apa ya, penjelasan lebih lanjut bagaimana kita mengajawantahkan tadi ethics di etika berbisnis, etika berperilaku, etika berinteraksi, fairness mesti ada, ya kan, sesama stakeholder maupun di lingkungan organisasi di mana kita berada. Meskipun kita atasan, kita punya kewenangan, kita tidak boleh menyalahgunakan kewenangan kita itu untuk kepentingan pribadi kita. Kewenangan kita itu hanya berlaku untuk selama kita menjabat satu jabatan di struktur organisasi. Sebagai pegawai pun kita mempunyai kan juga job description. Kita bisa bergerak. Kalau ada yang menyimpang dari itu yang bukan, itu ada whistleblower tadi kan. Apakah itu untuk etika atau tadi penyelewengan yang terjadi yang tidak sepatutnya harusnya dipraktekkan oleh kita sebagai company. Jadi hal-hal itu yang menunjang tadi bagaimana satu apa ya, etik di dalam lingkungan organisasi bisa dibudayakan, ibaratnya ya Pak Ais ya istilahnya ya, kebudayaan itu harus terjadi bersama. Jadi kalau individu-individu di perusahaan itu sudah mengetahui tanggung jawab pada dirinya sendiri terhadap sesama manusia, sesama di organisasi, maka itulah yang mungkin yang diimpikan oleh tadi model yang coba direkayasakan menjadi satu hal yang bisa dipahami dan bisa diajawantahkan. Terima kasih.
Wah.
Makasih, Ibu.
Terima kasih banyak nih, Ibu Shanti. Thank you ya. Thank you for the answer. So, ladies and gentlemen, Pak Ais ya, berarti di sesi ini duet nih Pak Ais dan juga
terima kasih.
Anyway, Bapak-Ibu sekalian, karena tadi pembukaannya bahasa Inggris, jadi ini saya tutup dengan bahasa Inggris ya. Gak apa-apa. Yeah, yeah. Oke, kita lanjutkan. Wah, oke. So, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, ya, we are already at the end of the sessions, ladies and gentlemen. Even though I can see that there are still a couple of, actually there's a lot, yeah, we have multiple questions that are still unanswered by us because of the time limit, but yeah, we are already at the end of the session. So I will now try to summarize and give the conclusions of our sessions, the ethical cultivation model. So ladies and gentlemen, Faiz earlier already mentioned and explained about the model that has three variables and also 10 dimensions to cultivate ethics, business ethics in organizations. I think that model is really comprehensive, ladies and gentlemen, and has been researched for a couple of years with thousands of respondents. Can you believe it? Because yeah, I think to apply and cultivate ethics is not that easy, but it is a must, right? Because we don't want business that just thriving and get so much money, but also ethical in its foundations, right? So that is the summary from me. Yeah. So right now I will invite the speaker, Pa Ais, to give closing statement
regarding our topic, Spies. The time and screen is yours.
First, I really want to say that by using this model, we have a door to start. We have a start point if one organization really want to implement the ethical activities in the or ethical cultures in organization. By using this model, first they can audit how far they are from the ideal of cultivating ethical model in organization. Then they know how they can fulfill this. By this model also, I think PPM will develop this model more than until we have a system where we can determine, we can calculate, we can have a number how far a company from the ethical implementation. So we will have target that we have to achieve to make sure that. Then based on that practicing, company can show to their customer, to their partner, that they are company who practicing ethical things in their company. How you prove that? We have this certified. If we use the something like certification, we can certify, assess a company. Then we can give certification in the some level, so they can show that they're really a company who responsible to the practicing of ethical culture in the organization. Thank you.
All right, thank you. What a powerful closing statement, yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so again, so let's give virtual reaction for Pak Ais. Virtual clap, hand clapping, maybe, ladies and gentlemen. And Pais, thank you so much for sharing with us, yeah, as the model that can be a start for the foundations of the more constructive way towards an more ethical business organizations. Okay, so I guess that is the end of the sessions, ladies and gentlemen. Again, thank you so much for all the participants and also the panelists who joined the sessions. I hope that the session can be beneficial for all of us, yeah? So good afternoon, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Good luck, stay healthy, and stay safe. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dave, keep the screen is yours again.
Oh, thank you very much, Yutin and Pak, for the interesting sessions. It's very interesting and very interactive. And for this, we're going to have a photo session. Are you ready? I want to have your best position, Pak. And the best smile, Pais.
Wow, right. Sure. Right. Okay.
Here we go. On my count, 1, 2, 3. Once again, 1, 2, 3. All right. Yeah.
Thank you.
Pais and Zitin, best of luck. And we are going to move on from the third session to the fourth session this afternoon.